in a world where extreme competition exists everywhere. What does it take to have success in your career and in life? Join me, Nirvana Chaudhary, as I sit down with some of the most successful individuals to discover the secrets to their success, what continues to drive them, and to hear a few exclusive stories in the process. What drives them and their success code, their mantra for making it bigger. Hello everyone, this is Nirvana Chaudhary. I'm back with my podcast, Making It Bigger. Today, I have with me a very dear friend, a young global leader, a renowned artist, also known by his name, El Cid. Fauzi is here with me and I'm so delighted to welcome him to Nepal. Fauzi, firstly, welcome to Nepal.
Thank you, Nirvana. Always a pleasure to be here and amazing to be with you right now.
So tell me, you know, my first question that I ask everyone. You as an individual, you as someone who is really changing the landscape of people's thought process, what is it that really drives you? What is your individual success mantra?
I think what drives me today, like, is, you know, always trying to challenge me, I would say. As an artist, what I love the most, and I think you will notice that, is those human experiences, you know, that I'm capable of living through my art project. And I think, you know, I'm kind of in this, there is a kind of thirst of always discover new stuff, you know, and always being able, you know, like to tell the story, you know, live a story, and also being able to tell the story and bring the voices of the people we don't listen to sometimes.
That's incredible. I think, you know, for me, music does a lot of that, where I feel the music is like the bridge between the heaven and earth, right? Between the minds of the people. And when you see an art, you see an expression, you see, you know, a story that's being told. So if you were to read an entire book, that could be captured in just one photo or in one piece of art, right? Tell me, I was intrigued by the work that you did in Egypt. Tell me a little bit about that. Like, why did you do it over there?
I wanted to raise the topic of perception and speak about perception and how people sometimes they are seen or perceived just because of all the misconception we have on them. And I found this community of garbage collector in Egypt, in Cairo. So they collect the garbage of Cairo and they manage to develop the most efficient recycling system in the world. They recycle 80% of what they collect. But because their image is attached to garbage, they totally marginalized. So with my team 5 years ago, we went there and we created an art piece that has spanned over like a 52 facade. And you can only see like if you go on the top of a mountain. And the idea was like to say sometimes if you want to see the real image of someone, you need just maybe to change your point of view, you know, your perception. So that was the goal of that, yeah.
So tell me, you know, today in organizations, we are always talking about succession planning and teaching people. And there's always this perception that, you know, in the art world, music world, you've just got to be born with that talent, right? I mean, you, your team's work, you just see it and you know it's your work. You have your signature behind it. It's something that stands out. How important is it for newer generations to either find their own individuality and their own signature, or is this kind of an art, can it be taught?
I think, you know, like you can teach techniques, I would say. You know, that's why I don't believe in the art school, you know, because I think art school teach you techniques and maybe a way of thinking, but then practice. I think work and practice will allow you to develop a certain signature. You know, sometimes people say like, I don't know how to create my own style. You know, I'm like, but you don't create a style, you reach it, you know, because being able to have your own signature is like because of mistakes that you make. Sometimes you take a path, you fail, and then you're like, oh, I made a mistake on this and this is something new, you know. So me, out of all the mistakes that I've done, you know, in my journey, sometimes like the biggest mistake were like the best discovery, you know. And I think this is how it's an organic process. This is not something that, there's not a recipe, you know, like, oh, I'm going to take a bit of this and this, and then I will find my way. So each parkour, I would say, each journey is individual, you know, and you have to find your own path. But I think the most important thing is work. That's
You know, I that was a very trick question, no, by the way. I feel the same thing in any aspect of life. You know, you finding your own strength, finding your own passion, finding your own signature, finding your own expertise, finding your own style. You know, if you're trying to copy someone's style or see a successful entrepreneur and I want to be like him. No, you get inspired by them, but create your own style. You know, absolutely. And that's why I think, I really consider you as a leader, who's changing the way perspectives and mindsets are working through the work of your art. COVID's happened, right? Now, how is that individually as Fauzi, as an individual, as a father, as a friend, as a brother, how has it changed your entire perspective towards life?
You know, I thought at the beginning that the world would change, you know, like I remember like at the beginning of the pandemic, everybody was like, oh, this is a reminder of our common humanity. Everybody is facing the exact same problem, you know, and then, you know, after time, you know, like looking at it from a different perspective, I realized that, I don't know, we forget really fast, you know what I mean? And I see that today. And that's funny because in Arabic, you know, the word human being, insan, comes from a roots that's, the roots of this word, insan, like human being, is the same roots as its roots from the word forgetting, you know?
Wow.
And I think, which is, so for me, it's like, is amazing. And I look at that, I think like, the mindset we were like a year and a half ago is not the same mindset. Where I think people now are trying to just be what they used to be. But the impact I think of on COVID on me as an artist, as a human being, is I just miss, you know, the fact of, sometimes I miss the fact of living those human experiences. So I think when I came to Nepal like 6 months ago was the first real trip of discovery, you know, coming to a new place where we don't know anybody, we don't know the language, we don't know the culture. And I think that's the big impact on COVID today, you know.
So, you know, artists and musicians are very different people, right? I think they first think from their heart and then the mind kicks in to rationalize that. I myself, I'm thinking like that, but I'm not in the art and music world. And I'm very happy with the way I think, right? Now, we keep talking about spirituality and how important is spiritualism, you know, a clear mind, a clear intent. As an artist, do you feel that, you know, as a human being, I first had a different perspective and I'm a different, I don't think logically, I mean, rationally, you know, like how the others think. And that's, do you think that's helped you to become a better artist?
Not thinking rationally. I think me today, I don't think rationally, but thank God I have Wahid with me. Oh, he's like really rational. So, and sometimes I think it's a good balance, you know, just for the people who are listening to this podcast. Wahid is my studio director, so he's the one like in behind all the projects that I've done. And so this is, I mean, you need this balance. You need to know what is possible, you know, technically. Technically is me, but sometimes financially also, you know, because you cannot do everything you want to do. And this is important. And also, I had the background of, you know, I'm an artist today, but I went to business school, which is weird, you know, and
an artist who went to business.
Yeah, yeah. I used to be a business consultant, you know. So I quit my job 11 years ago before my daughter was born. And this actually allowed me some time to find, you know, like to define some process. And I found some difficulties in some artists. They're like, I don't know how to do this. I don't know how to manage this. I don't know how to price my work. I think it's important that people realize today that being an artist, being able to live as an artist, is not just coming, you know, waking up and like painting or create work, but it's also a way of thinking. You know, if you want to grow as an artist, you have to also organize yourself. And for me, being an artist is the most complete, task. I hate to say task or work, but I mean, you touch to everything. You know what I mean? So that's, I love that.
You know, my father is an entrepreneur, right? And I really look up to him. And I keep telling him that the reason why you are such a successful entrepreneur is because you're an artist. You're an artist in your mind. You know, you're creating and painting something in a canvas which no one else is seeing. That's what differentiates you more than your other people. Last question I want to ask you is, do you believe in karma?
I totally believe in karma. Yeah, 100%. You know, I think... you know, we are the product of what we of what we do, you know what I mean? So I always say that to my kids. I say, you know, like, Earth is round. So if you throw something at somebody or you beat somebody, then it will come back on your back, you know? So you just go all around and come and hit you in the head, you know? So I totally believe. So that's why, you know, I think it's important to be aware of what we do and aware of our environment. And so.
You know, I ask you that because I really believe in karma. I really believe that everything's meant to happen. Yeah. You just have to embrace it, and that thing which is meant to happen is directly related to your own heart, how it's unfolding things. Yeah. You know, and I want to connect that to, you know, the fact that you're sitting here, you know, why are this here, team is here, and you've undertaken this new project for yourself, which is revolving around women from Nepal post-earthquake, having reconstructed an entire village, and you are now working towards reflecting an old poem by a Nepali poet talking about unity and showcasing that work in the model village that they've created. I mean, it's incredible. I just probably, before you go, just probably a few words about, you know, your overall experience about Nepal and your connection to Nepal through that project, apart from your connection to me.
Now, look, coming to Nepal like a few months ago was for me, and I think the rest of the team, like a blast, you know, was crazy. We discovered like a country that we had like no link with, but I found like, actually what I found in Nepal is humanity. I think if there is one word to define it, is humanity, you know. And this is funny because from, you know, like being here, sitting like on the rooftop, or when you go to, you know, like Sindalpachok in this little village, the warmth of the people is exactly the same, you know what I mean? And that's, I think, what touches, you know, the most, you know. And everything is easy, and I don't say easy in like in what we're doing as a project, but how people are receptive, you know what I mean? And you come, you say, look, I want to do this, and the people in the village, they were like, thank you for doing this, you know what I mean?
Oh, wow.
And this is, we felt that once in Tunisia when somebody told us, sometimes you need somebody from outside to tell you how beautiful you are. And I think that's the purpose of this project, you know, showing to the world, you know, like this, the power of this woman, you know, and through an art project. So it's putting the highlight on them and trying to give them, trying to echo their voice. I'm not taking their voice. We're making a documentary about it as well. So to make sure that they say what they will have to say, you know, it's not me saying what they want to say. And so that's I think how to resume Nepal is just saying this is really humanity. I think you feel it. So I invite everybody to come.
Great. Thank you so much to my beautiful friend who's come to a beautiful country doing some amazing and beautiful work along with this beautiful team. Thank you so much for being part of my podcast, and I really wish you all the best.
Thank you, Nirvana. I'm glad to be here, man.